As we take a look at the fuel manifold for an LM1500 for gaseous fuel, I would like to take this opportunity to apologize to my regular viewers. You can tell that the jet fuel hoax idea, those idiots have kind of gotten to me. They've gotten under my skin. They've stolen my footage, used it in videos to claim that engines run on air alone. And I'm trying not to respond to the trolls, and I'm having moderate success in that. Anyway, I never believed that so many people would find such a stupid idea so appealing, and they appear to have made themselves absolutely immune to the facts. Just amazing. They've got a perfect hard shell of ignorance around their very being. And it's fun to watch, but it's sad to watch because, man, oh man, just think. If they didn't run on fuel, why not leave them going the whole time? Use them as heaters. Why not just get free power? Why not? Why would you ever shut your aircraft off? Because the cost of maintenance, what we do here, the cost involved in maintaining the aircraft is usually caused by starting and stopping the engine, the thermal cycling of the blades in particular, and the combustors, right over here. They get very hot and they crack. And this is the hottest part of the engine right here, the first stage of nozzles. It's under a great amount of heat stress. An industrial engine can run for, 20, 30,000 hours with no maintenance to these because they're at the same temperature the whole time. They're 1,000 degrees, but they never change. And an aircraft engine goes right down to freezing cold when you shut it off overnight to 1,000 degrees, up and down, up and down, up and down, with every takeoff and every landing and every climb out. So aircraft engines have these parts inspected every 500 to 1,000 hours, depending on the engine model. So why not eliminate that cost? Because the maintenance can be millions of dollars on an aircraft engine. Eliminate that cost by just leaving them going the whole time. Why not? Well, you know there's a reason. And that reason is fuel. Okay, we're gonna head to the test cell. Thank you for listening to my rants and my description of the problem of stupid people. All right, cool. Special super secret bonus footage. This is the magical desk. This is what it looks like from the operator's point of view, the pilot's point of view, I suppose. It's quite nice. So now we're going to take a look at there's the side. It's beautiful. Beautiful. I think this is the cowling from a CF6. I'm not sure which actual engine it's from. We only got the cowling. Beautifully polished. There's me being reflected. Our little custom sign there. Ooh, that's cool. Handmade. And there you go. That is the famous desk. Full of work to do. Super cool. Special bonus, just for you. Hey, I just posted a video, but I'm gonna take it down and repost it because I have to add this little bonus. A couple days ago, I don't know if you can see this, in my messy room. Let's see, there's a Rana tea. He says, jet fuel hoax, I am willing to pay for the fuel bill by PayPal. Blah, 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 blah. And then I said some nasty things and he responded with some retarded talk about war and hiding and stuff. Anyway, let's see, here we go. This is a photograph of the fuel bill from the Executive Flight Center, the Fort St. John Airport, to SNS. Oh, let's see, let's do this. Leaders net, 1668. And the bill that we paid for that was, this is a small one, $1,644.94. So, Rana, prove to me that you're not lying. Prove to me that you're not a lying little weasel, because I guarantee that you will come up with a lame excuse to not pay. And this is a little one. I just heard from Special Agent Diaz that he has a $4,500 fuel bill. And this was in February. We got about 8 such deliveries because we were testing quite a few engines. So it's real money, it's real fuel, and I guarantee that you will not pay. Guarantee. Because you're a lying little weasel. Thank you. And all you other hoaxsters, buck up or shut up.